We thank you that we can call upon your name, knowing that you said, where two or three are gathered in your name, you are in the midst. And Father, we put the Henry family before your presence, O God, and we ask, Heavenly Father, that you will strengthen their hearts, Heavenly Father. Father, because we know according to your word that we have a high priest who's touched with the feelings of our infirmities. And so, Father, we ask, Heavenly Father, that you bless them and that the peace of God that passeth all understanding will keep their hearts. And, Father, for the rest of this service, we pray, Heavenly Father, that we ask for your divine blessings as we give you thanks. In Jesus' name, and we say amen.
Sim. happens is he had the remote control and whatever we wanted to watch could be, could it? He was just sitting in jury with educational stuff. Yeah, but good times, I don't want to miss him. I love my dad. I'm not sure it'd be good to see everybody turn out. Yeah. That's all really. Bit of stage fright in that.
Fondest memories of him is like when he used to go to the pub and he used to come back in the middle of the night and he'll wake us all up and he'll have patties for us or like Chinese food, which is a real treat. I'll miss him. Yeah, he was an inspiration.
I've got many memories of my granddad and fun ones. Yeah, one what sticks in my head when I was young, he used to take us summer to Overton Castle. If you're from Derby, you know Overton Castle. He used to take us there in this big old school blue car, consistent, I think it was like every Saturday or Sunday anyway, because my dad was working and that, and he wanted that quality time with us. He used to come in his shorts and like the picture you see here with his long white socks and his white trainers. Them trainers are decades old, believe that. But yeah, it kept him in good condition, man. But yeah, he used to come pick us up. And then one time, like, I must have, I think he was waiting in, because we missed Sunday school for it. And I think I was like, at the time, my mum also said, "Mum, where's Grandad?" So I was like, "No, ring him." So we're ringing and ringing out. Finally got through. He said, "We can't come today, you know." I'm saying, "Why?" He's like, me tied up. But the following week, we found out that he got banned for driving. Typical Grandad. We all know why he got banned, didn't it? Kind of didn't drink too much and he can't cool himself.
Nice and caring, and he always wanted everyone to do well. And he kept saying to me, "Jarrell, read a book." And Jarrell and me struggled to follow that rule. And yeah, that's it.
Ronnie and Daddy were very close, and our dad has passed, and I know the time they spent together was precious and well remembered by everyone. He used to love coming down to Derby and rolling back into Auntie's house late at night, and I know that Daddy's waiting with a drink up in heaven, so they're together, they are together, Auntie. Okay, may you rest in peace.
So my fondest memories of my granddad was when I would always come back from uni and he'd always be like, "So how's school going?" And, "Oh my god, granddad, it's been 2 years I've been at university." University, get that. They always used to tease me about that, but he seemed like he was quite proud of the thing that I was doing. And then a proudest moment for me was when I was able to go to the Vulcan with him. And hear about boasting off about all the grandkids and everybody saying how very proud of us and stuff. And I got to photograph that and use that in a photo of the young man that I got really free for, which was pretty good. But just, he was so proud of all of us, and I never really saw that when I was younger, but when I got older I could see how much he loved us and cared for us. And this is those kind of family face that I'm gonna miss, but I'm so glad that I've had the chance to have experience with him and, you know, like feel his love and how much of a benefit he's done with my mum and my aunties and my uncle, and how well me and my cousins have done that. It's because of how much he loves us, even though he probably didn't show it all the time. He did it in his own kind of small, special way. So, yeah, I'm going to miss him, and I didn't realise how much I would miss him because he was always there. But it's like a massive rock that's just kind of left us all. But just have to remember all the positives and all the kind of good stories that he had, and the good people that he met, and, you know, just celebrate the life that he had. And
when I met Ronnie and Frank, we became such great friends, and I loved Ronnie and Frank dearly, and I'm just a nobody from London. So I just want to pay my respect to Ronnie because we hit it off. We were very good friends. And Frank also. And I just want to say it's wonderful to be in this West Indian community service place here with all you wonderful people, and I feel honoured. I feel honoured to be in your company, and that's all I want to say.